Today, I'm going to quickly show you how to extract a still image from video in Photoshop. There are two methods that I'm going to show you. So if you go to open your video file in Photoshop and you get this message, you're probably on an M1 Mac computer, but that's okay. You could still do this. So this is an M1 native known issue, and it is coming. So to convert a video timeline option right here, it says open Photoshop using Rosetta. So all you need to do is in your Creative Cloud application is come over here to these three dots. And right here, it says open Intel right there and just click on that. And now you'll be able to do this tutorial in Photoshop. If you're running on Intel versions of Photoshop, no problem. So use this method if you want to work on one or more frames in Photoshop right away. For instance, if you want to edit or crop your image that you get from your video clip and you want to work on it right away in Photoshop. So you come up here to File, Import Video Frames to Layers, and you open up your video clip and you get this small window right here. You can scrub through your clip and come to a point where you want your frame. If you grab these endpoints and outpoints, and now you can see up here that Ranged Import, it's automatically selected range only. The further these are apart, the more frames you're going to capture. So I'll show you this real quick. So if I leave my endpoint and outpoint like this and say OK, you can see in the layers panel that it created all these frames as a layer. And this way you can go through and you can choose which one that you want. And you could see that there was a person walking through the frame just because of where I had chosen it. And maybe I just scroll up and choose the one where that person is gone out of the picture, and that's the one I want to use for my still frame. So if you want one frame, put your playhead to where you want to capture that frame. Move both the endpoints and outpoints as close as you can get them, something like that, and say okay, and you'll get one frame. And now you can edit your image here in Photoshop. So here's another example of how to get your still image out of your video clip. If you come up here to File, Open, select your clip and open it. Photoshop's going to open your timeline for you automatically. Here you have a much bigger view of your clip. To move your playhead to the point where you want to export your video clip, you have these in and out points right here, and it's the same principle. If you have these part like I've done right here, and if I come down here to this arrow, it says render video, and you get this panel here. You want to make sure that this says Photoshop image sequence. You could choose to export JPEG or a Photoshop document. I'm going to go for a JPEG, and it's telling you down here range, work area. So all of these frames are going to be exported out. And if you wanted, you could change the document size. But just to show you, if I render it, and you might want to choose a path, I'm going to choose images right here and say render. It's going to take a second. And if I go to the folder where all my images are, here they are. It rendered these all separately. Now, if you wanted to look at them in Photoshop, you would have to come up here to File, Scripts, Load Files into Stack, and I can get a whole folder here. There it is. Say open. Here's all the images in the folder. And it opened them all as layers here in Photoshop. And this way you can choose any of the images that you want. But then just like the other method, if you move your playhead to the point in the clip where you want that still image, these endpoints and outpoints, move them right next to each other. And then come down here to this arrow, render video, select a folder where you want it to go, what format, make sure it says Photoshop image sequence, and down here, work area, it says 136 to 136. I'm going to get one frame because I moved these in and out points right next to each other as close as possible. And I say render, and I've got one image that exported as my still from my clip, and there it is in Photoshop, so I can edit it. And it just depends on your workflow and what you want to do as to which method you choose. I hope this video was helpful. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.